Is it him? Is that the first son of Odin?
I'm to your eyes.
Oh, they see everything. They see you leading us to hell. Wake up! We are all dead. Can you not see? You're a destroyer, Odinson. See where your power leads.
Yo, what up, everyone? Tay here. And a shorter video today, and we are going to talk a little bit about Loki. So let's get into it, but first, like, subscribe, all that good shit, you know the drill. Come hit me up on Twitter, click the bell, and all of that. And yeah, anyways, let's talk about Loki. Okay, so the other night on the 12th was the launch of Disney Plus. So I got it all set up, got my account going and everything like that, and the first thing I watched was the new Expanding the Universe featurette on all of the upcoming MCU shows. And in that, we got a few little tidbits of, you know, useful information. And most of the info we got was on the Falcon and the Winter Soldier show. We also got to see some cool concept art from that, which I am going to be talking about that show in one of the next videos, but for now, I want to talk about Loki. Okay, so anyways, when we got to the Loki section of the featurette, there was a few things that piqued my curiosity. First off, producer Steven Brassard confirmed that the Loki series will include time travel, and one of the exact quotes that Steven Brassard said was, "There's a huge time travel component, and there will be a man-on-the-run quality to it." And this made me wonder, first off, who is Loki on the run from, and what will this huge time travel component be? In the show, how is it that Loki will be able to travel through time? Well, the only two ways we know of in the MCU to time travel is the quantum realm mixed with Pym particles and the Time Stone.
Ah!
And in a recent Bloomberg article, Kevin Feige revealed that the Loki series, very much like the WandaVision series, will be connected to Doctor Strange 2. And it's also been reported that the Loki series will connect to and set up Thor 4. Now, if we look at the Phase 4 schedule, it looks like WandaVision is coming out just before Doctor Strange 2, and then Loki is coming out just after Doctor Strange 2, and several months before Thor 4. Now, in just a second, we are going to discuss how Loki will potentially be able to time travel in the show. But before we do that, I just wanted to preface it by saying that Loki's connection to Doctor Strange 2 will likely tie into the multiverse, since the Loki show will start off in 2012 in a branch reality timeline. So when we talk about time travel and how exactly Loki will be able to time travel in the MCU, for now we can only talk about what we know about time travel from past MCU films. So it's possible that the MCU will introduce a new means of time travel that's somehow connected to the multiverse or multiple realities that we don't yet know about, and that Loki figures out some other way to travel through time than the other stuff we're going to be talking about in this video. So I just wanted to throw that out there, since we are still pretty far away from the Loki series and a lot can happen between now and then to, you know, kind of fill in some of those gaps. But anyways, now let's get back to the Expanding the Universe featurette and the connections between Loki and Doctor Strange and how Loki could potentially time travel with what we know so far.
So I keep a watch list of individuals and beings from other realms that may be a threat to this world. Your adopted brother Loki is one of those beings.
It's a worthy inclusion.
And then something else I noticed during the featurette is when they got to the Loki section of the featurette, as the logo for Loki was forming into the screen, you know, they're doing all these letters kind of coming together and everything. And while that's happening, you can see this pulsing green light in the background, which reminded me very much of the Time Stone. And I've put some screenshots that I took from it on the screen here so you can see what I'm talking about. But yeah, this looks to me like the Time Stone, and it made me wonder if they are possibly teasing the Time Stone. And we know that the Loki series will pick up with Loki after he escaped with the Tesseract in Avengers Endgame. Now, of course, Loki cannot time travel with the Tesseract. He can only portal himself to different locations. And in Avengers Endgame, Bruce goes to the 2012 version of the Ancient One just down the street and borrows the Time Stone from her. But then at the end of Avengers Endgame, Cap takes all of the Infinity Stones back to the exact time and location that he initially took them from. And Loki is very smart and very cunning. And during this scene, just before he escapes with the Tesseract, you can see he's the only one that's really observing everything that's going on. That while everyone else is freaking out about the 2012 version of Tony, Loki is paying attention to everything else, and you can see the wheels turning in his head, that he's kind of putting some stuff together. So it's possible that Loki was able to figure out everything that was going on here, that the Avengers from the future had traveled back in time to get the stones from the past. And one of Loki's regular abilities and tricks that we see him do all the time is that he can appear as someone else, or he can also make other people appear as someone else.
I have eyes on Loki. I'm not Loki.
So after Loki disappears with the Tesseract, he could have been spying on Tony, Scott, and Steve, and Bruce, and kind of figure out what was going on. And once he did that, from there, he could have gone to get the Time Stone from the Ancient One, who's just a few blocks away down on Bleecker Street at the Sanctum. And with Loki being so sneaky and also having the Tesseract, he could probably do that. But either way, the point is if Loki gets the Time Stone, he could then use it to go back in time. And apparently he'll be on the run from someone, according to Steven Broussard. And that's made me curious as well, because who is Loki on the run from? I mean, you have to remember that this is at a time when Loki is at the peak of his villainy during the first Avengers movie. This is the 2012 version of Loki. So at this time, Odin, Thor, Heimdall, and the forces of Asgard would all probably be after him, so that would make sense. Then there is also the 2012 version of Thanos, because Loki was working for Thanos at this time to get the Tesseract, so Thanos would probably be very upset with him, so that could be one of the reasons that Loki goes back in time in the first place. And in an interview that Tom Hiddleston did back in August, he made some remarks on the Loki series, and he said that in the show, Loki will be going up against formidable opponents, and he said opponents, so plural, that are opponents he's never seen or known before.
But there's also, it's the Loki
of 2012, basically.
Yeah.
So he's still, he's not redeemed.
That's where he starts, and then seeing him come up against more formidable opponents, the like of which he has never seen or known. I wish I could tell you what happens, but I can't.
So, based on those comments, it makes it sound as if there will be multiple villains or antagonists in the show, and that they will be new characters that we've never seen before, and also characters that Loki is not acquainted with in the past. And I think the most likely scenario for who the villain or antagonist of the show could be will be that they are characters that are tied to Asgardian mythology, something to do with Asgard. Because again, you have to remember the show starts in 2012, so Asgard will still be a place and Odin will still be alive. And it's been reported that the Loki series will also connect to Thor: Love and Thunder, and that perhaps Loki will appear in Thor: Love and Thunder as well. So a villain that's connected to Asgard would also make sense on that front, as Marvel Studios could then connect that story or villain or whatever it is to Thor 4. But for that to happen, Loki would have to cross back over into the main MCU reality and timeline. And there's been a lot of speculation that that is how Mjolnir will be brought back for Thor: Love and Thunder, that Loki will somehow bring Mjolnir back from the past of that branch reality into the present-day timeline of the main MCU reality that we will see in Thor 4. But anyways, now let's get to the question of who the antagonists or villains of the Loki series could be. Okay, so in that Tom Hiddleston interview clip that I showed a second ago, he made it sound as if there will be multiple opponents that Loki will have to deal with and face off with in the show. And from what's been reported on the Loki series, it sounds like each episode of the show will occur in a different point in time, with Loki having influence over significant events in human history. So with that in mind, perhaps there will be a different opponent for each time period that Loki is in. But that then raises the question, will there be an overarching villain for the entire series that's going after Loki? You know, a main villain, if you will. Perhaps a character or entity that's aware of Loki's ability to time travel and can somehow catch up to him or follow him or is aware of what Loki's doing. Because Marvel Studios producer Steven Brassard said that in the series, Loki will be on his back foot for the first time and that Loki will be on the run from someone or something. So perhaps there could be a multiversal being or some kind of dark entity that's aware of Loki's manipulation of the timeline and is unhappy with that. And this could be an entity that ties back into the whole multi-dimensional horror aspects of Doctor Strange 2. But this is a Loki series, and it will be setting up the events of Thor: Love and Thunder. And since the show is taking place in different past timelines where Asgard still exists and Odin is still alive, that makes me wonder if one way or another, Loki will either be on the run from an enemy of Asgard or Asgard itself. Because you have to remember, at these different points in the past, Heimdall will still be alive. And of course, Heimdall is all-seeing. He can see what's happening in all of the nine realms. And at the beginning of the first Avengers movie, Thor first comes to Earth so he can capture Loki and bring him back to Asgard. But then in this timeline of events, that never happened. Loki was never taken back to Asgard at the end of the first Avengers movie. He instead escaped with the Tesseract. So it would make sense that Asgard would still be looking for Loki to capture him. And no matter what time period Loki is in, that time period's version of Heimdall could find Loki. And Asgard could then send someone after Loki to capture him in that time period. Now, I know this is all getting a little convoluted, and these are just hypothetical what-if scenarios, but it is fun to speculate on what could happen. And having a scenario along these lines happen in the Loki show would open the doors for Marvel Studios to introduce important Asgardian characters from the comics that we have yet to see in the MCU. For instance, introducing someone from Asgardian mythology like Baldur or Angela would be very cool, who in the comics were also children of Odin and siblings of Thor and Loki. However, the only thing with that is they already introduced Hela as Odin's mystery daughter in Thor Ragnarok, so introducing another child of Odin might be a little confusing because you would wonder, well, where is this Ban and why have we never heard of him in past movies? Another character who I think would be perfect is Kull Borsun, the Asgardian god of fear. And in the comics, Kull is Odin's older brother and one of the most powerful and ruthless Asgardians there is. And another reason why Kull could make sense is that he was a prominent part of Jason Aaron's The Mighty Thor comic series, which we know is being adapted to some degree into Thor: Love and Thunder. So introducing him in the Loki series could possibly lead to his appearance in Thor 4. But yeah, I think Kull would be perfect as a villain in the Loki series because he is one of the most scary Asgardians in the comics, and that just seems like it would make a lot of sense. Another character that would make sense and could set up future characters and MCU films is the dark sorceress Morgan Le Fay, because introducing her could help set up future characters like Doctor Doom, and could also tie into the Black Knight, who we know is being introduced in the Eternals movie, and could also tie into stuff that's going on with Doctor Strange. And I think Morgan Le Fay could work well in the Loki series because she's a character that has appeared throughout centuries of Marvel history in the comics. And then lastly, a villain who I think would be very, very cool to see in the MCU in general is Gorr the God Butcher. And don't forget that Loki is the god of mischief, so Gorr going after Loki would make sense. And I'll be honest, I don't know how likely this one is. This one I think would be very cool, but I don't have a lot of confidence it's actually what's going to happen. But then again, there have been reports and a lot of speculation that Gore will go on to be the villain of Thor 4, Thor Love and Thunder. Now again, I don't know how much I really believe that, but let's go down the rabbit hole anyways of how Gore could be the villain in the Loki series and how that could set up into Thor Love and Thunder. Okay, so first off, Gore was the villain in Jason Aaron's epic God of Thunder series. And not the whole series, but I think it was like the first 11 issues. And in that series, it jumps back and forth from different points in time because Gore is hunting Thor throughout time in different points of Thor's history. And in the finale of the story, it has three different versions of Thor all joining together to defeat Gore. There is the young Thor, the warrior, the present-day Thor, the Avenger, and the older future Thor, the Destroyer. Now, if Gore did end up being the villain of Thor 4, it would have to be quite different from the comics, because I don't think that Thor 4 is going to span centuries of Thor's history, and I obviously don't think we are going to see Chris Hemsworth play three different versions of Thor in one movie. However, the Loki series is going to follow Loki through different points in history, and Thor 4 is going to have more than one version of Thor. So the Loki series could set up Gore's backstory as he hunts Loki down throughout history, and then 6 months later when Thor Love and Thunder comes out in November of 2021, that story could come to a finale with Loki, Thor, Valkyrie, and Jane Foster Thor joining forces to defeat Gore. Now, I know that's totally going down a rabbit hole of speculation and that the chances of that happening are not super high, but it's just a hypothetical cool way that they could do Gore the God Butcher in the MCU and tie it to the Loki series, and think that would be cool because Loki is going to be jumping around at different points in time, and in that comic, that's how it was, only instead of Loki, it was Thor, so they could kind of start it out and tease Gore in the Loki series, and we could see him as well as some other villains in that series, and then we could really get Gore in Thor Love and Thunder. But again, like I said, I'm pretty skeptical of the whole Gore being the villain of Thor Love and Thunder in the first place, as much as I would love that because Gore is such an awesome villain and that comic series is so good. But if it does happen, maybe that's how it'll work. So yeah. Anyways, come hit me up on Twitter, hit me up with topic requests. I'm going to be doing some other topics coming up. I'm working on a video where we are going to talk about Deadpool in the MCU and how rated R content could be handled under Marvel Studios. And in that video, we are also going to talk a little bit about how Spider-Man could cross over into Sony's Spider-Verse or Venom-Verse, whatever you want to call it. And then I have another video I've been working on that will be a bit different, where we talk about the history of censorship in film and pop culture. Don't worry, we're still going to be talking about the MCU mostly, but I would like to start talking about a few other things kind of sprinkled in between videos. So yeah, anyways, please like and subscribe, come hit me up on Twitter, all of that, and if you would like to check out the full interview with Tom Hiddleston, I've linked that down in the description, and you can also find the links to recent MCU videos down in the description below as well, so you should check some of those out. Alright, cool. Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and I will be back soon.